refraction of light through a triangular glass prism. Okay, see, I'm going to draw the triangular glass prism I'm taking, and I'm going to show you how refraction of light takes place through it. For that, the things which we need are, we need a ruler, a prism, a triangular glass prism, a protractor, and then I have taken some color pens to show you the difference, one eraser in case if I need, and pencil should be very sharp, so I have taken this, and four pins I have taken, thumb pins. Okay, so first I have put the heading as refraction of light through a triangular glass prism. As we have studied in the theory part, first I should take the triangular glass prism, and we know that we are having a glass prism is having two triangular shaped structures and three rectangular shaped structures. Okay, so before starting this activity, first I should keep this prism on the sheet like this. Okay, I'll keep this on the sheet, and then I will just draw the outline. First, while drawing, no, it will be difficult because it is little bit slippery. It will move here and there. Okay, so I have taken like this, and then I will try to adjust. Like I'll draw the edges with the help of pencil. Okay, now I will label it as A, B and C. This is the prism which we have taken. Now in this side AB, this is the refracting surface. Okay, here in the middle I will keep a point. See, I will keep a point like this, any point I can take, and I will draw the normal. I'll draw the normal like this. For normal, we'll put dotted lines, and I will mark it as N, N dash. Okay, I have marked it as N, N dash. Now, with the help of a protractor, I am taking a protractor and keeping it in the center. That means on the normal line I'm keeping, so that it should be 90 degrees. The normal which I have taken, no, it should be 90 degrees. From here I will start counting. We will take 60 degrees. Okay, it can be 60 or 45, but we will take 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will keep a point like this in 60 degrees. Now what I will do, no, I will draw a line on that. Okay, and yesterday I told you that the difference between two pins should be 5 centimeters. So I'll mark that also. One pin I'll keep it here, and the next pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here I'll keep the next pin here. To make it clear, I'll put a round also next to that. Two pins I am going to keep it here. Now I know this is the normal, and this one is the incident ray. Which is this ray? This is the incident ray. So I will name it as P and Q, these two pins. And this is angle of incidence. So angle of incidence is equal to how many degrees I have taken? 60 degrees I have taken. Okay. Now what I will do is, I'll keep this prism. See, I'll keep the prism, and I will take two pins. Usually while doing this practical, no, they will use a wooden board. Now the lab is closed, so I'm not able to get it. So I'm using a book. This is just to keep the pin. Okay, so I have used a book below this. So I'll put a pin here, straight pin. This is a thumb pin. Using our thumb, we should pin it. and I'll put one more pin this side. Okay, so now I have put two thumb pins. Okay, I have put two thumb pins. Now what I will do, I'll keep the prism like this, and in 30 degrees, see here, you will also be able to see everything. Now if I keep like this, no, this pin, see, you're not able to see, I'll show it to you. I have kept the pins, no. So if you see, if I come to this side and if I see the pins are here, I have kept the pins here, I'll come this side, and if I bend my head and see, the pin is seen here. You'll also be able to see it. Now keeping this, what will I do? I'm seeing the pin, no? I should make a straight line. So now those two pins are there. Keeping that in mind, I'll put a pin, straight line it should be. One. Now if you see, all the four pins are in a straight line. Right? Able to see anything. Okay, all the four pins are in a straight line. Now after this, what should I do? I have pinned it. Now I'll get two points here, one point, I'll remove the pin. And one more point I'll get, I'll remove the pin. Okay, now I'll remove this prism. I don't want that. So what I will do is this also, I'll join these two. Okay, I join these two and I will mark it as P, Q, R, S. These two are also two pins. The point where I mark, no, the perpendicular to this, I'll draw one normal. And I will label it as M, M dash. This is the next normal. Okay. Now between these two, I'll mark it as E and F. The point where it is coming and hitting the prism, no, I'll mark it as E. And from where it is moving out, no, I'll mark it as F. Now I'll join E and F. Okay, I have joined E and F. Now this I have taken it as angle of incidence and it is 60 degrees, and this one I'll mark it as between this refracted ray and this one, no, I'll mark it as angle of refraction, and between this normal and this one, no, I'll mark it as angle of emergence. Okay, so angle of incidence, angle of refraction, angle of emergence, all the three I have marked. Now what I will do is, I will extend this line. This incident ray, one line was there, no? I'll extend that line. Okay, and I will mark it as H. This line also, this emergent ray which came out, no, that also I will extend. And I will mark it as G. Okay, G and H I have marked. I forgot to tell you that this is equilateral prism. So all the three sides will be 60 degrees. So this end A is also 60 degrees. Okay. B is also 60. C is also 60. So angle of A is 60 degrees. Now these two things we join, know that part, that angle is called as angle of deviation. It can also be denoted by delta. In the theory class I told you, it can be denoted by delta. Now we will, after drawing all these things, it's done. We should mark everything. Now this is the incident ray. We have put one arrow here. This is the refracted ray and this is what? Emergent ray. Incident ray, refracted ray and emergent ray. And this is angle of incidence, angle of refraction, angle of emergence, and this is angle of prism, that is 60 degrees, and this is angle of deviation, these two parts. So we will write down everything. PE is equal to, see this is PE, is equal to incident ray. Okay, and EF is equal to refracted ray. And FS is equal to emergent ray. So all the three rays we have written. Now angle I is equal to, this area is called as angle of incidence. This is angle of refraction. Angle of refraction. This is angle of emergence. This is angle of prism. And this one is angle of deviation. We know that we should measure and find it out. Angle of incidence plus angle of emergence is equal to angle of prism plus angle of deviation. You will get it like this. Okay. So we should measure and find it out whether those things are matching. Angle of incidence, we know we have taken 60 degrees, no? If you want to check it once, you can keep this in the on the normal, this baseline, and this should match. And here we will count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is equal to 60 plus E is equal to, E how will you measure? You will keep like this and you will measure. This line should be on this 10, 20, 27. A we know always it is 60 plus B is equal to, we should measure. How to measure? We'll keep it like this, exactly 27. So angle of incidence plus angle of emergence is equal to angle of prism plus angle of deviation. See, same way you should also draw and find it out if you have a prism. After coming to school, we will do this activity. One more also I have. See, this is 60 degrees and this is 55 degrees. I got 55. Same like that, here it is 60 and here it is 55. So both should be same. That's all. 60 plus 27 is equal to 60 plus 27 I got here. Same way here, 60 plus 55, that is angle of incidence plus angle of emergence is equal to angle of prism plus angle of deviation. It should be the same. Okay, this is how refraction of light takes place through a triangular glass prism.